I'm from Medical Institute of Technology. I pursue BTech from Computer Science and Engineering branch.
Hello guys, I'm Sumit Rai. I'm from IIT ISM Dhanbad. I'm pursuing Bachelor of Technology in Electronics and Communication Engineering.
Hi, my name is Kevin Thomas. I'm from Sengit's College of Engineering. I am doing BTech in Computer Science and Engineering.
Hi guys, my name is John Thomas and I'm from Sengit's College of Engineering. I'm pursuing Computer Science and Engineering.
Our project is wider face and person's challenge, track to pedestrian detection. This is a live Roda Lab challenge. The aim of our project is to detect pedestrians and cyclists which are of the same class. Our dataset comprises of 92,000 images which comprises of test, training and validation sets. Dataset which comprises of the images and the annotations was a little tricky, so the pre-processing part was a hard part. There were several models to be considered for our project and we came up with faster RCNN because it has a greater accuracy than YOLO V3.
YOLO, you only look once, is a state-of-art real-time object detection system. It reads the whole image at the test time, so it don't need to read the images again. Its predictions are informed by global context in the image. It also makes predictions with a single network evaluation system, unlike RCNN and faster RCNN. So it gives much higher speeds, like 1000 times more than fast RCNN and 100 times more than faster RCNN. But with higher speed, it gives less accurate results. So we adopted faster RCNN over YOLO.
So guys, as you know, we have been studying faster RCNN. Before this, we have tried other models also like YOLO, but they all failed to give outpass the benchmark. So this is the final training on faster RCNN. So before this, to understand this part, we have studied RCNN, simple RCNN, fast RCNN and faster RCNN. Simple RCNN and fast RCNN were not performing so good because they were having different parts of RPA network and detection network. RPA network was using selective search which performed poorly, but then detection network was used. These two parts were separate, but in faster RCNN, these two parts are shared. So our data set is pre-processed and fed into the RPA network, that is reason proposal network. This reason proposal network uses a base network like MobileNet V1, VGG19, ResNet 50, or any such network like ResNet Large also. As you all might be knowing about ResNet Large, it is one of the latest models. Okay, so these basic networks are pre-trained models which will give feature maps, and these feature maps will be fed into the reason proposal networks, which will be and this network will work on intersection over the union process, and it will make anchor boxes also. Like for a value say k equal to number of anchor boxes, it will produce 2k values of classification. Whether it is related to that part, whether the object is there or not. So we are, for each k anchor boxes, we have 2k outcomes, and corresponding to this, we have 4k coordinates. For each k anchor boxes, we have 4 coordinates, so there are 4k coordinates in overall. And so for a reverse, for one single box regression class, we have 4k coordinates. Okay, and so this RPA network is first trained, and then the output weights and JSON model file is fed into the detection or classification network, which is the final layer of our faster RCNN model. This final layer will give a tightened bounds of the regression box, that anchor box. The bounding box which will be formed on the detective images. The pedestrians and cyclists will be detected and it will be visible to us via the bounding boxes. The confidence score will be predicted by the softmax function, and the tightened bounds of the regression box will be done by a linear regression. As we have done it, the loss function is related to linear regression only. So now I will show you the training part of the RPA network. As you can see here. So guys, as you can see, this is the command to start the training of RPA network. I am starting the training now. It is using TensorFlow backend. As you can see here, it is parsing the annotation files. It will take some time. Now the weights are loaded. Now training is beginning. Epochs are set to 300. Here you can see the estimated time is 20 minutes. It is reducing. The loss is at the beginning is 7.95. RPN out class loss is 6.31. RPN out regression loss is 1.31. It is reducing. As we know, the model is getting trained and the loss will reduce. So it will take time, and after 300 epochs, we tried to reach till 500 epochs and got an accuracy of 88% with mobile net even.
So we can conclude, in terms of training the region proportional network, that mobile net outperformed better than the VGG 90 and the ResNet 50. Since the predictions were more accurate, and only if the RPN network is trained properly, we got that the mobile net gave an accuracy of 88% after training for 500 epochs from a dataset of 400 images. With this, and after removing the faulty annotations of the images and reforming the dataset, we got 85%.